So, back by popular demand, we had a heap of people asking why we didn't show all the rest of the bagging process, which obviously includes debagging and seeing how your product comes out in the end. So this video is going to show me debagging it, pulling the bag off, showing how much bleed off we ended up with in the end. It's a bit more than I'd hoped for, but you know, that's life. Yeah, so the video is going to show what it looks like and how the consumables come off, and what actually gets left over or thrown in the bin, which is a bit of a becoming quite a thing for me from the marine industry, how much waste we produce building these boats, particularly the higher performance ones. But yeah, anyway, here's the video. Turn the vacuum pump on. I've got to be quick because this is going to evacuate my bag fairly rapidly. Still got lots of big holes in it. Just lots of flow. I'm going to start manipulating my bag to sit where I want it to sit, making sure that in these corners here. Now that the bag's roughly where it needs to be, go around, squishing all the tacky tape in, making sure it's all sealed because I've got lots of little tiny air leaks between the hole and the tacky tape. And I can hear the air running through the frog's mouth. Look, there it is, it's my biggest one. You can see the resin starting to bleed through all those little perforated holes. I need to keep working around, making sure that my bag is well and truly pressed, and you'll be able to hear all the leaks now in the bag. I'll go around now, pressing down on the leaks. There you go. And as that happens, the atmospheric pressure starts pushing down heavy on the bag, starts squeezing the carbon hard against the hull, and any excess resin gets squeezed out through the holes and then ends up in breather felt. Right, now that I'm happy that I've got a good back on there, so we want to get the resin to go off as fast as we possibly can now. So I'll set up a little temporary bathroom heater and tent arrangement to pump heat into it to get it to kick off nice and fast now. So here's the finished product after the resin's cured. The bag is now ready to come off. You can see that we've had quite a good bleed, that it's actually bled and filled the whole breather felt, which is indication that quite a bit of resin was used. And you can see that the frog's tongue has worked, that the resin has entered the start of the frog's tongue and only made it this far to the tacky tape. But the rest of it, no resin at all, so there's no resin that's gone into the breech valve or the vacuum pump hose. So I'm gonna now pull apart the stack and show you. So you can see here that the tacky tape is really gooey and it's leaving residue all over the it was raining the other day, so it's water here as well and dirt crap. Normally this residue from the tacky tape gets left on the boat, and that's why I use the masking tape to mask the boat up so that we don't end up with the tacky tape residue on the boat, which is really hard to clean up. pull this bag off now. And we'll get the next one out so you can see that. Right. Bags come off pretty easy. Alright, now you can see the breather felt and the perf plastic. So you can see the job of the perf plastic. The breather felt's coming off very easily now. Without that perf plastic, red stuff there, that breather felt will stick to this like no one's business and impossible to come off. And now you can also see the peel ply in the stack down here. If I pull the peel ply off a little bit, I can pull it all off. And that's left a nice, slightly resin rich textured finish for me to now hit with the sandpaper and tidy it all up. Yeah, finish pulling this all apart. And now you can see the vacuum bag has nicely consolidated the carbon around this corner into this concave here, around the end of my tube here, into this corner. So it's pressed it in nice and firmly, kept all the fiber pushed into everywhere I wanted. And because I had no bridging in my bag and no bridging in my peel plies and stuff, it's been able to slide and move into this corner and push everything where it needs to be. Red dirt everywhere from the rain. There you go. Alright. Ow. See a tiny little bit of wrinkling here, but not too bad, and you can see the extra patching that I put in the corners here where I nicked the carbon. So there's an extra layer of cloth that went over it, and you can see the build up of the stacks from here to here. But in general, it's come up quite nice. There you go. Quite a nicely finished vacuum bag part. Pull the peel ply off, give it a sand up, and she'll be ready to be covered with paint. Right, so here we have, unfortunately, one of the bad things about vacuum bagging is the waste. So the perf plastic and the breather felt, that's all for the rubbish bin. Back bag, generally in the professional game, if we're building someone else a boat, we won't recycle it because the chances of it being holed again very high. As you can see, there's little tiny like needles of cured resin in the bag. And if I was to pull a vacuum on that again, this cured resin, which is quite sharp, has a very high chance of piercing the bag, creating a hole and a leak, which then creates big problems down the track. So 90% of the time, or 99% of the time, the back bag doesn't get reused, goes in the bin as well. So unfortunately, there's a lot of plastic waste in this process. It's probably nearly as much plastic going in the bin as what I glued onto the boat, but that's the process, unfortunately. So here's the totally debagged and lightly sanded part. This is now ready for a quick wipe of filler and paint. You can see that it's taken very little sanding to get it to the stage of needing filler and being smooth, just straight out from under the bag.
What are we going to do with it next?
Fill it, sand it, and paint it.
Paint it? What colour? Have you heard you were going to change your mind from black?
No, we haven't got many options from black because I bought black paint, which is probably going to be a cock up because...
No, you can't use cock up.
Because it's going to be so bloody hot.
Looks cool though. Alright. Thanks, you can go back to building your trampoline now.
Building my trampoline? Well, I'm just sanding and laminating inside of holes.
Oh, that's right. Maybe you should ask about that.
Yeah, finishing off that little joy.